Hi, this is your brother Ferdinand, and I'm bringing this edition of Truth in Brief from the city of Lagos, where I came around to speak in a conference. And it's a question that the Lord Jesus Christ asked Joseph and Mary. Joseph, his foster father, and of course, Mary, his mother. And actually, a combination of two questions in Luke chapter 2 and verse 49, Jesus said, "Why did you seek me? Why are you looking for me? Did you not know that I must be about my father's business? Why are you looking for me?" I'm sure you know the story. This was when Jesus was 12 years old and they had gone to the temple, and of course they left him behind without knowing. And after 3 days, they found him in the temple reasoning with all of these Pharisees, scribes, and all the teachers of the law. And they say, "Why did you treat us like this?" And then Jesus replied with a question as a 12-year-old. And he said, "Why are you looking for me? You should know where to find me. Didn't you know that I must be about my father's business?" Brothers and sisters, our father has business. I said our father has a business. And all responsible sons and daughters must be about the father's business. I believe the biggest reason why the church is where it is and things are the way they are is because most believers, all of us, are after our own businesses. Everybody is busy with his business. Everybody has his own priorities, his own agendas. But Jesus said, "I must be about my father's business." I must. It's a compulsory a commitment the Lord has made. And do you know that it was where Jesus was pursuing the Father's business? That's the business that brought us salvation. That's the business that purchased every benefit that we have in Christ. And that is the business that secures, you know, us for all time and eternity. And I have found personally that you cannot put the Father's business first and then be forgotten by the Father. When you attend to the Father's business, the Father himself will attend to the things that concern you. You will not be looking for what to eat or where to sleep or what to do. Listen, you are going to work, but the blessing of God is going to rest on you. Because God, he said, "Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness." And then what is going to happen? He said, "Everything else will be added to you." I'm in a hotel room here. Some, you know, God provided. Of course, I preach the gospel. People, we are blessed and transformed and ignited to serve God. I want to be about the Father's business with my time, with my money, with my mind, with my body, with this one life. Do you know it's only one life you have? You are not coming back. And the question is, what business are you pursuing? A lot of people wake up in the morning and run out. They don't even talk to the Father and say to the Father, "What is your business today? What are you doing today that I can be engaged in?" The Father's business is his harvest, souls for whom Jesus died, building up his church. Does it mean you are going to resign from your work? No, not necessarily. Because your work is a platform for doing your Father's business. And if you set your mind on doing the will of God, pursuing the agenda of heaven, and laboring with God to glorify his name on earth, he will supply all of your needs. I am a living testimony. He provides. Sometimes I sleep in a good hotel like here. Sometimes I sleep in the bush. We go to villages. I remember going to one village in northern Kenya. We slept in this hut with smoke pouring out of the place. The bed was made up of sticks and the mattress was cow skin, cow hide. We slept on it and preached the gospel to the people. Be about the Father's business with your money, with your time, with your household, with your children, with everything that you have. And you will find yourself proven wise for time and even for eternity, because the Father himself will bless you. Divine jealousy will watch over you because you are pursuing something important to God. Eternal Father, put fire, zeal in our hearts. Jesus said, "Zeal for the Father's house has consumed me." Father, let that be our testimony again in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. That, Lord, all that we are with our families, our resources, our time, we will serve you and advance your kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen. If somebody was looking for you, where will you be found? They see, the children say, you should know where to find me. You should have come to the Father's house. That's where you will locate me. May you be located on the Father's vineyard, advancing his will upon the earth. Bye-bye.